Is the combination of Tylenol and ibuprofen still the combination of choice for pain control?
Find out today on Medical History Mystery.
Everybody, welcome to Medical History Mysteries. I'm Dr. Pam Maragliano-Muniz, and with me, as always, Tom Biola. What's up?
How's it going, Pam?
Oh my gosh, so good. And I'm going to say, it's like cocktail hour. We're going to spend the next few sessions talking about some cocktails, not the super fun kind after work. We're talking about drug cocktails. So today, let's talk about ibuprofen and Tylenol. And where is that? Is that still kind of the combination of choice or the cocktail of choice instead of prescribing an opioid for pain control? Is there anything new? And can you remind us of the doses?
Can we use ibuprofen and acetaminophen together to get the optimal pain relief that we're looking for? Absolutely. Why do we love ibuprofen so much? Well, we know that dental pain is acute inflammatory pain, and therefore the best way to treat it would be with an anti-inflammatory. We love ibuprofen. Why? Because ibuprofen is dosed about every 6 hours. And we know that dental pain, as acute inflammatory pain, seems to flare up about every 6 hours. So why can't we use ibuprofen and not have to worry about it? It's a lot of pills. You're dosing every 6 hours. And the dose itself is relatively high. So most people will say, we need about 600 to 800 milligrams of ibuprofen to truly treat dental pain. Why? Well, if you look at the data, ibuprofen has a ceiling dose of 400 milligrams for its analgesic effect. Anything more than 400 milligrams, you're not going to get any more pain relief. But ibuprofen has an anti-inflammatory effect of about 600 to 800 milligrams. Okay, that's a pretty big gap. So what does that mean? Well, either I got to raise the dose and risk more side effects to get my anti-inflammatory effect, or I've got to lower the dose to relieve the amount of side effects I might get, but also get less anti-inflammatory activity. And therefore, we can say, as I like to say, that ibuprofen is a great anti-inflammatory, but it sucks as a pain reliever. What do you do in that situation? Well, we rely on synergy. We know that acetaminophen, when added to ibuprofen, creates a synergistic effect that would allow us to get the same effects that we normally get, but at lower doses. So by adding the acetaminophen, we can lower the dose of ibuprofen to about 600 milligrams, or maybe even 400 milligrams, and get the anti-inflammatory effect we're looking for. And that was actually promoted by a study published in early part of January 2023 this year from McMaster University that said, we really only need 200 to 400 milligrams of ibuprofen. But that's not necessarily what everyone has adopted out there. Most clinicians say, we need 600 to 800 milligrams of ibuprofen for true anti-inflammatory / pain relief when we combine it with acetaminophen. Okay, but it's a lot of pills, right? Using Advil at 200 milligrams each, even if you went with the 600 milligram dose, that's 3 Advil. And since it's dosed every 6 hours, that's 4 times a day, that's 12 pills. It's a lot of pills. So let's use a longer acting NSAID. So it's less pills during the day. Let's use Arutis. Let's use, Relafen. Let's use Mobic at once a day dosing. But that's the paradox. The paradox is, as I try to extend the duration of action to get less pills in a day, I'm moving away from the optimal every 6 hour dosing, which matches up with the way dental pain flares. So we go back to ibuprofen, and that's why I say, I think the best thing you can do as a dentist these days, or if you're a hygienist that practices in a state where you can dispense, where you could prescribe the ibuprofen 600 milligram or 800 milligram tablets. Now, when I say this, people say, what do you mean? It's over the counter. Welcome to the United States, where you get the same drug by prescription or over the counter, depending on the dose you prescribe, right? So I'll prescribe the 600 or 800 milligram tablets and the pharmacist will fill them. And therefore, instead of taking 3 Advil, I take 1 600 milligram ibuprofen, right? Okay, but the better part of that is the placebo effect. I walk out of that pharmacy with that huge bottle of pills with the huge tablets inside. And I say, what? Look at the size of those things. That's got to be better than the over-the-counter crap you can buy. May not be any better, but people sure think it is. And that means what? Less pills, more compliance, and the idea, the placebo effect of, these must be better. They must work better. And maybe, in fact, they do, because you believe they work better. Now, the same study from McMaster University promoted the use of 1,000 milligrams of acetaminophen. I'm not on board with that. A lot of clinicians I speak to aren't on board on that, because we know that the maximum amount of acetaminophen you can take in one day is 4,000 milligrams according to the FDA, but 3,000 milligrams according to the manufacturer of Tylenol brand acetaminophen, because they know acetaminophen is found in so many other places, NyQuil, DayQuil, Tylenol, cold and sinus, Excedrin. So they want to give us a 3,000 milligram dose instead of 4,000 to give us a 1,000 milligram buffer in case, you know, you're taking other forms of acetaminophen and don't know it.
Wow. So, all right, I got a few things out of this. One, people love their horse pills. Is that like, I don't know if that's like a New Jersey thing, but like a big pill, they call it a horse pill. Is that like a
absolutely? Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So people like their horse pills. So you can prescribe them a 600 or 800 milligrams, but we're still kind of sticking to the 3,000 milligram a day acetaminophen guideline, even though technically this article states that we could even go a little bit more with it. But obviously staying on top of it every 6 hours, we're just not going to be safe.
A lot of clinicians recommend 600 milligrams of ibuprofen and 500 milligrams of acetaminophen 4 times a day for dental pain, because in addition to the fact that we want to stay at 3,000, let's say, to give people that buffer for other forms of acetaminophen, we want to go down another 1,000 milligrams, perhaps, because we may prescribe an opioid. And all opioid analgesics that we use in dentistry contain acetaminophen. If you told someone to take 3 Norco in one day, which isn't outside the realm, that's 1,000 milligrams of acetaminophen right there. So we want to have that extra buffer. And that leads to the greater point, Pam, of why don't we just prescribe opioids? And the answer is, we're worried about contributing to the opioid epidemic, certainly. But quite frankly, with the number of tablets we prescribe, I would say if anybody asked me who's the most likely to most appropriately prescribe an opioid, I would say it's a dentist or a dental professional, because we only prescribe the smallest amount of doses for the smallest period of time at the smallest dose, because that's what we're all about in dentistry. You know, we don't compare it to some medical professionals out there who prescribe 90, 120, 180. You know, we're giving out 6 or 10. Basically, we suck, but that's okay, because we love us for that reason. We keep the use of opioids to a minimum. And remember, not in place of, but in addition to the ibuprofen and acetaminophen combination, as like an emergency break glass sort of thing.
So we have consumers, that non-dental professionals, patients, if you will, that watch our videos, which, hi, we're so happy to have
Hello.
You. But I think we should just kind of break it down one more time. So if you are going to mix Advil and Tylenol or ibuprofen and acetaminophen, we're looking at 3 Advil to 1 Tylenol every 6 hours for pain and inflammation.
That's what I can't say that's my cocktail, because I can't take credit for it. This is what I've gained and garnered from speaking to thousands and thousands of dental professionals across the country. With all due respect to McMaster University and anybody else out there who has a different formulation in mind, I'm with you 100%. You know, I would never want to tell anybody how to practice, but this is what I've heard from most people. Correct.
Okay. Well, keep us updated as these things change, but I don't know. It sounds like a ceiling's a ceiling. We probably shouldn't play with that.
I agree. I think, you know, do what you do. If it's working for your patients, keep doing it. But don't forget to add the acetaminophen if the patient can tolerate acetaminophen, because it really does work wonders along with the ibuprofen.
Awesome. Well, together, everyone achieves more, right?
Correct.
Okay, everybody, for Medical History Mysteries, we will see you next week.
Thanks, everybody.
Bye.